Greetings, John. I'm glad to be back here on your show once again. It's an absolute honor and a privilege.
Welcome to episode 6 of John's Talent and Hobby Talk Show. My next guest is voiceover artist Joe Mignano, who we met in episode 1. Since then, he has moved on to hosting his podcast, Dark Empire Radio. In this episode, we discuss his transition from his old YouTube show to his current podcast.
How did Dark Empire Radio originate?
Well, Dark Empire Radio originated in February of 2010 as a small little podcast, the official podcast of the Dark Empire Costume Club, which I joined in 2009. February of 2010, I came to the realization that although I had quite a bit of a following with my old YouTube web series, The Dark Side Chats, I realized that podcasts seemed to be a lot more popular. I only had a couple of hundred subscribers, probably not even that many at that point for The Dark Side Chats. And so I decided as an experiment, I thought I would start up a podcast while still doing The Dark Side Chats as I was starting to wind it down. I was getting kind of tired with that show and running out of material. And back then in those days, 2008, 2009, 2010, when that show was on, YouTube videos were only allowed up to about 10 minutes, and so I had to cram what material I could do into a 10-minute show. And of course, now that that show is done on YouTube, YouTube videos can have a lot more than 10 minutes. But getting back to the podcast, you can have an unlimited amount of time in a discussion on a podcast, and we've had a lot of fun on Dark Empire Radio, and even though it's audio and not video, nevertheless, we've had indeed a lot of fun. It's not just the official podcast of a costume club. It's intended for all Star Wars fans, even though it might have a bit of a focus on the dark side, but it's a lot of fun, and I've had the pleasure and privilege to be able to host and produce it. Hey, it's my podcast.
Is there anything like your old show, The Dark Side Chats?
Well, Dark Empire Radio certainly is a lot like The Dark Side Chats, and in fact, I kind of like to think of it as a continuation of the old web series. Maybe not quite as campy as the old web series was. That thing was filmed right here in my living room. Nevertheless, it was a fun web series, and The Dark Side Chats will remain on YouTube. You can watch all of the old episodes there on YouTube right here at youtube.com/Goofy 92688, kind of a weird, campy little web address. But then again, the whole show was campy. That was the premise behind it. That show was very unpredictable. Dark Empire Radio probably isn't as campy, but it's still a lot of fun. And there are a lot of things that went on the Dark Side Chats that, we here on Dark Empire Radio do. TDSC, as I used to call it, The Dark Side Chats, was an exploration of Star Wars fandom. And it explored everything, from costuming to maybe a little bit of gaming to collecting, even though I'm not a big collector. These are just autographs and posters. maybe I collect autographs. There's so many aspects of collecting, whether it's action figures or books or autographs, and TDSC explored that. And we on Dark Empire Radio, in addition to describing the goings-on in the Dark Empire Costume Club, we also like to interview celebrities, which also occurred on the Dark Side Chats, and proprietors of Star Wars fan websites and other costumers, and you know, it's a lot of fun. In fact, one of the good things about the Dark Side Chats that I did not do on TDSC is that I narrate Dark Empire Radio is 2 years old as of February of 2012, and we've been narrating fan fiction on that podcast, and because, hey, I'm a voiceover artist, and so I like to encourage people to write fan fiction and give them incentive. I read it on the podcast. As a matter of fact, John, I'm reading one of your stories right now.
What's the basic format of each episode of your podcast?
Well, the basic format of each episode of DER, Dark Empire Radio, is, it's very simple. We always start off with each episode with my trademark, greetings, and then we tell people how many members we have in the group. It's an ever-growing number, And then we talk about events and convention reports, business pertaining to the Dark Empire, the goings-on, mission reports, trooping events, that kind of thing. And then we get into the fun. We always have what we call a triangle discussion or an interview with a celebrity. It depends on what we get for a particular episode. If it's whether it's an interview or a discussion about a particular topic, topics can range from, like I mentioned in the answer to the last question, they could be topics about Star Wars in particular. One of my favorite topics recently was actors that we feel, that although they did not portray Sith Lords in the movies, actors that we feel should have been Sith Lords in the movies. And my Alec Guinness was my choice for some very compelling reasons. Check that out in episode 56 of Dark Empire Radio. And it's just an absolute blast to be able to do. We have discussions that are that deep. And so feel free to give it a try. All you have to do to find Dark Empire Radio, of course, is go to thedarkempire.org or look up Dark Empire Radio on iTunes.
What have you been able to present in your podcast which you couldn't in your old show?
Some of the things that I've been able to do on the podcast that I couldn't do on the Dark Side Chats, well, as I mentioned, the narrated fan fiction, there definitely wasn't time on the Dark Side Chats to put narrated fan fiction on there, which is something I always wanted to do. Aside from that, of course, being able to talk about the Dark Empire, I'm their public relations officer, we call that the Tyranari, and, it's just a lot of fun. And being able to, I think, being able to put an hour-long podcast, or more, some of our episodes are 2 hours long, we like to keep it around an hour and an hour and a half if we can. Really, just being able to put all of the material that I want to put into a show, I can do on Dark Empire Radio that I never could do on the Dark Side Chats. Primarily, I think the narrated fan fiction is my favorite part, but we've got more segments coming up. We're about to introduce a new segment called Dark Side Costuming 101, which won't be hosted by me, but it will be adding it to the show soon, and one of our members in the Dark Empire, one of our approved costumed members, is going to be offering some costuming advice for prospective members. So that'll be a new segment that we're going to be launching soon. But in a nutshell, I find with the audio podcast, it's a lot more popular, and definitely I can put whatever I want in there. There are no time limits as like there used to be on YouTube, and it's a lot more fun. And being an audio show, not a visual show, I'm using the sound effects and things that I can do audio-wise, it's a lot easier to put together. And I enjoy audio editing much more than I do video editing. But that's okay. I have no problem video editing what I'm filming right now for you. Once in a while, I'll do something like this. I don't mind. Not at all.
Your alternative character, Vasily, is also in it. So what role does he play in Dark Empire Radio?
Yeah, I'm Vasily Gikovich Popov. I'm sometimes regular guest host of the Dark Empire radio show, just like I was on the Dark Side Chats. Haha, it was very funny. I used to be called Vasily Popov. Then two people from Russia called, one of them is called Vasily Popov. They said to the brutal guy, get that Vasily guy over there. He said no good. But you know what? I Vasily changed my name. Or add it Gikovich to middle name to my name, so now I am Vasily Gikovich Popov. It's good! Let me tell you about those Dark Empire people. Hold on a minute. I have to calm my nerves. Okay, now then, those Dark Empire people, you know what they do to me, Vasily? Every time I am on that that podcast of theirs, Dark Empire radio show, they kill me. They send me to back the tank all the time. Because you know why? The Dark Empire Costume Club make me honorary target. It's no good. But you know what, that's okay. I do not mind recording it, sometimes guest host it or whatever, the Dark Empire radio show. It's a lot of fun, and maybe kind of fun for the listener, too. It's good. Brutal guys are coming back. He's not so good. Bye!
How well is Dark Empire Radio doing as a podcast?
How well is Dark Empire Radio doing as a podcast? Well, I think that's up to the listener. We get a lot of mixed feedback. I think primarily it's all positive. People like what they hear. We're certainly not the most popular Star Wars podcast out there. There are plenty of others, and some of the most popular of which, of course, are The Force Cast, Star Wars Action News, The Sarlacc Pit, The Wampa's Lair, The Star Wars Report, and many, many others. But I really enjoy the uniqueness of Dark Empire Radio. Again, the narrated fan fiction, the Dark Empire Costume Club, the events, the Troopering Reports, the unique interviews and discussions that we've had on the show, I think make it unique that there's material on there and, that you don't find on other podcasts, including some of the words from our sponsors that are put together by yours truly, and deep thoughts with the Brutal One. That's just stuff that you don't find on other podcasts. In fact, we've made some of those available for individual download, the commercials, and even some unique ringtones. If you go to thedarkempire.org and hover your cursor over where the tab that says Dark Empire Radio, you'll see a drop-down menu for some exclusive content, and even merchandise, like this shirt. But hey, enough with the sales pitch. And we don't profit any on this, of course, at all. All of this goes to help with defray the cost of the podcast. It does cost a little bit to put together, and I don't mind doing that. It's a lot of fun to put together, and I hope people enjoy listening to it. In fact, I know people enjoy listening to it, because according to our statistics, we have more than 20,000 subscribers. I believe we're somewhere in the neighborhood of 23,000 at this point, and that's fine. I really don't care if we have 200 subscribers or 200,000 subscribers. As long as I'm able to produce something that somebody out there enjoys listening to, I'm satisfied, and I'm hoping that you're satisfied. And we like feedback, so let us know how we're doing, of course. We might even read your email or play your voicemail on the show.
Thank you, Joe. It's great to have you back on my program.
Thanks for having me, John. It's been a lot of fun. And now for a little Star Wars wordplay that I came up with. Introducing Sawapnees. Star Wars planet names in sentences.
You haven't spoken to me for weeks. Ain't a day go by I don't think about you.
She is so hot.
So Luke, am I gonna get paid? Not a Felucia.
That man over there with the needle, he's tattooing.
Give it your best spin.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Pirate, did you find that buried treasure by any chance?
Nar, shut up.
That soloist can sing, but that chorus can't. Oh, shut up, it was a good one.
Y'all gotta drive real big cars these days. Y'all know what happened when my sis crashed my little old Geo? No, sis.
I must have farted.
Is this the end or not?
Do you have any swap knees? You know what I mean. If you can come up with a swap knee of your own, put it in the comment section of this episode.